It's a good morning from Thimphu again. So today we move out of Thimphu and we move on to our next destination, that is Punakha. But on our way to Punakha, we are crossing through the Dochula Pass. So I'm going to tell you more about the pass, but the drive up till this point has been absolutely scenic. Now the Dochula Pass has 108 stupas. So we've just stopped here to see those stupas. I'm going to give you a quick tour of how the pass has been constructed. A little history about the Dochula Pass. Now Dochula Pass stands at a height of about I think 10,000 feet, and this actually has a story behind it. So in the year 1990, there was a terrorist occupation of a certain part of Bhutan by some Assamese terrorists. In the year 2003, the Bhutan government grew tired of this terrorism, and they actually declared war against these terrorists. This war was actually fought only for 2 days, starting 15 December and ending on 17 December 2003, when these Assamese terrorists were actually driven away out of the country. And the Queen Mother, which is one of the four queens of Bhutan, actually built 108 stupas on the Dochula Pass to actually commemorate this victory. So this entire complex is sort of like a symbol of victory against terrorism. So apart from the stupas, there's another very, very special thing of the Dochula Pass. Now, because Dochula Pass is situated at a height, you can see how misty and beautiful and cloudy the, you know, weather is. And if you manage to have a clear day, you can actually see the 9 tallest peaks of Bhutan from this point. But you really have to be lucky, because most days at the Dochula Pass, the weather is going to be cloudy. There's a lot of cloud cover. It's quite cold, so remember to carry a jacket. But if you're lucky and you plan it well in advance, if the weather gods are pleased with you, you can actually sight the 9 tallest peaks of Bhutan from this point. So we have arrived in Punakha and we are out for river rafting today. How excited are we?
Very excited! Woohoo!
The drive to reach this point of river rafting has been so beautiful. We have been driving parallel to the river and the river border is beautiful. Now this rafting will actually depend on the weather. Right after monsoons, there are like really nice rapids and you can do like a lot of fun rafting. Some summer months the water dries up, but today we have a decently like a fair amount of water, so we are going rafting. The cost for rafting per person is coming to around 2500 to 2700 per person. Have arrived at the Punakha Zong now. Now Zong is basically this beautiful structure that has a shrine inside. It also has some administrative offices. Now let me tell you a little something about things that you need to keep in mind when you're coming to the Zong. Firstly, there's no photography or videography allowed inside the temple for obvious reasons. You have to be modestly dressed, so whenever you come here, make sure you wear something with full sleeves and full pants. Also, the entry fee per adult to enter the Punakha Zong is 500 Bhutanese Nirgram. Zong is essentially a place of worship and an administrative office. The Punakha Zong was built in the year 1638 and it's the second oldest zong in Bhutan. This is actually a very, very important spot for the country, because this is where every king in Bhutan was coronated.
That shrine only for 4 person. The in charge of the temple, the king, present king, his father, the 4th king, and the religious head, the abbot. Only 4 persons where they are allowed to go inside. So like common people or like even the royal family, we are not allowed to go inside, okay?
After finishing the Punakha Dzong, we have now come to the Punakha Suspension Bridge. We actually saw the bridge yesterday when we went rafting, and we're actually going to walk all across it. I'm going to tell you guys more about the bridge, but look at this beautiful landscape, the bridge and then the river flowing. The river water is so beautiful. Just one thing to keep in mind, it's a little bit of a climb to reach the suspension bridge. It's about a 10-minute walk, so be prepared for that. Now, this bridge is about 180 meters long, and this was actually built back when there were no motorable roads in the area. So basically, people living on the other side of the river used to transport goods and whatever other necessities by using this bridge. Now it's used more for like tourist and photography purposes, but it's so beautiful because the river water flowing from below and then all the greenery, it is really, really pretty. Just make sure you come at a decent hour because it tends to get really crowded. So if you're looking to get like good pictures or something, make sure you time it well so you're not here in the middle of the day. Priyanka, are you ready to eat the ice cream?
Yes.
On our way to Paro right now, and for lunch we've stopped at this very, very cute place called Kukham House. They serve a bunch of local specialties, and we have actually decided to go for their buffet. I love eating local buffets wherever I go, so I'm going to take you through the spread. So we have rice, they also have their special homemade bread, chicken gravy, another cabbage preparation, an eggplant preparation, and there's a potato preparation. And along with this, for spice lovers, they also have their Bhutanese chili cheese, which is emadakchi, and then this freshly made pickle salad sort of a thing, which has tomatoes, onions, and lots of chili.
Some unique flavors.
Now, the special thing about this ice cream is that they put a little shot of rum on top of the vanilla ice cream. This is actually a unique combination. This is the first time I'm trying this out, and it's pretty tasty. We have stopped for a coffee break at this place called Om Amriti Cafe. So it's like this cute cafe in the middle of nowhere. All of the buildings here in Bhutan, like, you know, have this very similar architectural elements. They all have these wooden panels and wooden windows, and they have this beautiful, colorful facades on top and everything. And everything is so pretty and cute. Like, even we're literally stopping at the most random places during our road trips. Every coffee shop or every like lunch home that we're stopping at is like really, really pretty. And so this cafe has a beautiful view. It opens out on the other side in a valley. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please come back for the next episode as well. And until then, please hit the subscribe button.